Les voy a decir quién soy. Yo soy Pablo Emilio Escobar Gaviria.
Pablo Escobar was one of the most notorious kingpins in modern history. But the kingpin status got his cartel $22 billion a year. And it gave him a spot on Forbes' billionaires list for 7 years straight. Of course, Escobar had some of the biggest houses, the fastest cars, and the craziest parties that you can imagine. But when you're bringing in such a massive haul, you gotta get creative on how to spend it. And man, did this dude get creative. So let's hop in and see how this jerk burned through, literally, his massive amounts of cash. Quick disclaimer. Look, I know this sounds weird, but I gotta sub out the D word in this video so that a certain website doesn't demonetize it. So I'm gonna use bread instead of, you know, Okay, let's hop into it. Just imagine for a second, if you had more money than you knew what to do with, how would you actually spend it? Well, naturally, Pablo spent his money to have some of the most insane parties that Colombia had to offer. I won't get into many of the details because let's just say that it's not exactly safe for work according to YouTube's monetization standards. I'm begging you, please don't demonetize this video. But what I can say is that these parties were so insane that many of Colombia's top politicians, policemen, and celebrities were spotted at Escobar's lavish parties. Also, let's talk for a second about the parties the bread lord threw for his kids too. It's been reported that Escobar used to stuff the piñatas at his kids' birthday parties with wads of cash. Honestly, that seems so much better than stupid Tootsie Rolls. If you've ever seen even an episode of Netflix's Narcos, you can just get a glimpse at the lavish estates and homes that Escobar owned. One of the craziest of these was his estate in the Colombian countryside, which went by the name Napoles. One of Escobar's sons wrote all about this crazy place in a book he wrote after his father passed away. In this book, he recounts the estate basically functioning as an airport. On any given weekend, there could have been dozens of planes parked at the estate. And most of those airplanes were owned by one of the crazy rich people who would have attended Pablo's parties. But anyways, Napoles had a landing strip, 2 helicopter landing pads, 10 houses, 1,700 employees, 27 artificial lakes, life-size dinosaur statues, and 3 zoos. We'll get more into detail on those zoos later, but yeah, you get the picture. Escobar's Napoles estate is one of the most insanely rad estates in history. But of course, the fact that the entire estate was basically bought with blood money spoils pretty much everything that's cool about this place. Of course though, if you have basically an airport attached to your property, you gotta have airplanes and helicopters to use as well. And let me tell you, Pablo Escobar definitely had his fair share. He owned everything from luxury private jets to military aircraft. But what is having a bunch of crazy aircraft if you don't have a bunch of dope cars to go with it? After raiding multiple of Pablo's homes and estates across the country, the Colombian authorities found Escobar's massive collection of vehicles that were used for bread dealing activities, as well as his own personal cruising around town cars. He had everything from a 1930s Cadillac to a Mercedes 300 SL. The most impressive car in his collection? How about a Porsche 911? This car, simply speaking, is quite the quick boy. Also, there's only 15 of these cars in existence, which leads many people to believe that this was the crown jewel in Pablo's garage. It's clear to say that Pablo was definitely too fast and way too furious. Alright, I know you guys were all waiting for me to get back to the fact that Pablo had 3 freaking zoos at his Napoles estate. Honey, we bought a zoo. Anyways, yeah, so Pablo smuggled elephants, tigers, hippos, and all sorts of different exotic animals to build a zoo on his estate. He even opened the zoo for the public to bring their kiddos to. But when Escobar's estate was seized in the early 1990s, all of the animals were dispersed among Colombia's zoos. Except for the most dangerous animal in the park, the hippos. Escobar had smuggled 3 female hippos and 1 male hippo into his zoo, And dang, did they get it on, if you know what I'm saying. The neglected hippos surrounding the Napoles estate grew their population to approximately 50 or 60 hippos. And now, in very Jurassic Park style, at least 12 of them have escaped down the nearby Magdalena River and have freaked out a couple of fishermen along the way. Pablo's little zoo experiment has now led to Colombia to have an actual invasive hippo problem. What a mark to leave on the country, along with all those other marks he left. Yikes. Whenever you're bringing in $420 million a week, you have to have a way to organize your cash and banknotes, right? Most people might put all that hard, cold cash into, I don't know, a bank account maybe? But Pablo was dishing out so much bread, he knew that he couldn't use the conventional means of keeping his money safe. So what kind of solution did Pablo and company come up with to stash their cash? Yup, rubber bands. In fact, Pablo Escobar spent upwards of $2,500 a month on rubber bands alone. This, of course, seemed like nothing when you're running a multi-billion dollar bread-dealing empire. But still, I can't imagine putting $2,500 a month into anything, especially not on a motherload of stretchy boys. Okay, so Pablo's got his cash wrapped up in some rubbery boys now. But still, where does he put the cash? According to reports, Escobar would hide huge amounts of his cash brought in by his bread cartel in Colombian farming fields, dilapidated warehouses, and in the walls of his minions' homes. According to Pablo's brother and accountant, Roberto Escobar, the kingpin would have him write off $2.1 billion a year in losses due to rats eating the money or money just being ruined by the elements. Sounds crazy, right? But because Pablo had more money than he knew what to do with, it was absolutely fine for him to lose literally billions of dollars a year to the elements. Remember when SpongeBob and Patrick were making so much money off Pretty Patties that they didn't know what to do with it?
Such a brilliant idea!
At first, we didn't know what to do with all the money. We tried burying it, shredding it, and burning it.
Well, what if I told you that Pablo Escobar actually ended up burning a substantial amount of his cash? It was a casual night for the Escobar family. They were just hanging out in their mountainside bunker in Medellin, Colombia, while Pablo was hiding from the cops. But apparently Pablo forgot to pay the heating bill because his daughter Manuela quickly became hypothermic. So what did Pablo come up with? How about lighting a fire using $2 million he just had lying around as kindling? I guess when your cartel is bringing in $420 million a week, you can throw some of that money up in flames. In order to run one of the most notorious bread-dealing empires in the history of the world, you had to be a master manipulator. In the 1980s, Escobar decided to run for public office in Colombia. He did eventually get elected to Congress, but he had his sights set on a higher position than that, the presidency. Luckily, Escobar never reached that seat, but he sure did try to get the public on his side to get him there. Escobar ran on a platform that pictured him as the candidate of the people. In order to convince the poor people of Colombia that he was really a candidate that was fighting for them, he handed out cash and built a vast amount of houses for the poor. He also built 70 community soccer fields, and I think it's safe to say that that zoo didn't hurt the public's opinion of him. Disgustingly, many of the people Escobar manipulated referred to him as Robin Hood. But it's clear to see now that he was just exploiting the poor to gain more power.
What a bread bowl.
But luckily, it seems like the jerkwad that was Pablo Escobar was eventually brought to justice. Sort of. In 1991, Escobar surprisingly submitted to the Colombian government, but he had to set some conditions, of course. Basically, Escobar agreed to turn himself in if he could be imprisoned at a private prison he run himself called La Catedral, or the Cathedral. And yeah, you can imagine that this thing was pretty nice. It was tricked out with a soccer field, barbecue pit, and tons of patios. And for some reason, the Colombian government agreed to let him choose who he wanted in the prison with him, who the guards would be, and of course, the Colombian authorities could not come within 3 miles of the property. So basically, although Pablo Escobar was in quote, prison, he got to run his cartel from another one of his luxurious homes that was disguised as a prison. Well, that's it. Answer in the comments below which of the animals you'd like to go see in Pablo Zoo. Also, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell button to join our notification squad. Thanks for watching The Richest, and we will see you soon.